Good morning. Last lecture, we have seen the path loss of the flat diagram. Flat diagram means if transmitter and receiver both are fixed with the plane surface, plane ground surface. So the path loss corresponding to that flat diagram is known as propagation path loss between the flat surface. This come under the flat terrain path loss. Today I will discuss about the point to point path loss model. Point to point means basically what is the propagation path loss between the transmitting and receiving antenna which are situated at the not the same surface, not the plane surface, but transmitter may be situated at the hilly areas and receiver may be the plane surface, or vice versa, means either transmitter is fixed at the plane surface while the mobile unit or receiver is fixed at the some slopy region, some hilly region. So this will today I will discuss about it. Now I am discussing about the basically these are related to the mobile communication. Clear? So previous lectures we have seen the what is the causes of fading, what is the causes of attenuation. So these are related to the propagation path loss. Clear? So last lecture we have seen basically this is the what is the wireless communication, types of wireless communication, typical frequency range which are used for the basically different type of the communication purpose. Right? Why wireless communication are used? Because in wired communication, the total communication cost are increases because of the some physical medium, some transmission medium. For example, if you transmit our signal from here, Udaipur to Delhi. Now, distance between Udaipur to Delhi approximately 900 km, 8 to 900 km. If you are putting or installing some physical medium, some wires, some coaxial cable, it is too much cost. So wireless communication is basically reduced the total cost of the communication. But there are so many challenges of the wireless communication system with the efficient hardware. Now these all things I discussed in the previous lecture. Representation of the mobile radio signals, description of these mobile radio communication characteristics, and last lecture we discussed the propagation path loss model over the flat region. Now previous lectures I discussed prediction over the flat region, basically how to this, what is the signal strength of the direct wave which are coming from the transmitting antenna, and what is the signal strength of the reflected wave. These are discussed in the last lecture. Today I will discuss about the area to area path loss model. Area to area means what is the propagation path, propagation loss between transmitting and receiving antenna if these two receiver and transmitter are installed in the flat region, open region. Clear? Or it is the urban region. Urban region means that is some developed region, in city region. What is the propagation path loss in the suburban region? Suburban region basically this is the mix of the developed and undeveloped region. So before starting the area to area path loss prediction, now I would like to know about the some areas. The model for the predicting propagation path loss. So what is the propagation path loss for the first method? That is the open land. Open land means undeveloped or partially developed farmland with conventional small dwellings and barns and sparsely populated area. So we have to predict the propagation path loss basically these regions: open land, industrialized open land, suburban areas. Suburban areas means basically this is the mixed residential and clean industrial uses, that is warehouses, shopping malls, light manufacturing and moderate vehicle traffic conditions. These all are under the suburban areas. Basically, next we have to calculate the propagation path loss between the urban areas. Urban areas means some city areas, some developed areas. Or we have to calculate the other areas known as the small to medium size city. Small to medium size city means the densely populated residential and commercial areas with well-defined business district characterized by number of high buildings and few, if any, skyscrapers. Clear? Where the traffic density is usually moderate to heavy, depending upon the flow of patterns and time of the day. So these all are under the small to medium-sized city. Now, next, last one, last area, basically known as the large-sized city. Large-sized city means this is a heavily commercial and industrial with many high-rise residential structure. Business district are characterized by many skyscrapers. Basically, the conclusion is for the large size cities, traffic density is heavy virtually all the time. So we have to calculate the propagation path loss between these areas. Between these areas is open land, industrialized open land, suburban areas, urban areas, small to medium size city, large size city. Clear? So this is the different areas where we have to calculate the path loss, propagation path loss. Clear? Now I am going to discuss the area to area path loss prediction model. So the formulation of the area to area path loss prediction model, basically where PR is the received power, PR naught is the received power at the free space. For example, suppose this is the transmitting antenna. If we are talking in terms of the communication system, this is the base station or transmitting antenna. Suppose here, mobile user or receiver. So there are two types of the signal reaches at the receiving antenna, either by the direct wave, this is known as the line of sight, or direct wave. Other by the, suppose wave coming here and reflected back. So this is the known as the reflected wave. Clear? So we know that suppose this is the E naught is the electric field in the direct wave in the free space. Why? This is denoted by E. This is the electric field or scattered field or reflected field corresponding to reflected wave. Right? So this PR is the power at the receiver side, while PR naught is the received power through the free space. PR naught and the power received through this is the PR. Clear? So in area to area path loss prediction, the field strength of the received signal is defined by PR equals to PR naught gamma R upon R naught power minus gamma. Power minus gamma means if we plot the graph between the received power strength with the distance, suppose sometimes signal is found like this, sometimes found like this, sometimes found like this. So this is the gamma 1, this is the gamma 2, this is the gamma 3. Basically, this gamma 1, gamma 2, gamma 3 represent the path loss slope. This gamma represents the path loss slope. Right? So this is formulated by the PR received signal, received power at the receiver side equals to PR naught, means signal received through the free space, into R upon R naught power minus gamma, into F upon F naught power minus N, where gamma is the path loss slope, where and R is the distance. This R is the distance between transmitter to receiver, or base station to mobile unit, and R naught is the distance measured in the 1 mile. Where R naught is the distance which is measured in 1 mile, right? And F is the frequency of the operation, where F naught is the fixed frequency of the operation. Clear? While now you can see here R is the basically distance between base station to mobile unit, and the unit is the mile. R is again 1 mile, where R naught is the, we have to calculate now this difference with respect to the 1 mile. 1 mile basically this is the intersection point. Intersection point of distance. Intersection point of distance. Right? So this is the linear expression. If you find taking the log of this first equation, now you will get the dB expression of the received power. The dB expression is Vr0 minus gamma log of R upon R0 minus L log of the F upon F0, and where plus alpha naught. Alpha naught is the basically the adjustment factor. Clear? Where the adjustment factor alpha naught equals to alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha 3, alpha 4, alpha 5. So these are the multiplication of different factor alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha 3, and alpha 4 and alpha 5. Now these alpha 1 and alpha 2 are specified the adjustment factor in the different situations. So you can see here this value. This n is belonging from, ranging from, now this is n is either 20 dB to 30 dB. This n is ranging from 20 dB to 30 dB. Now you can see here, basically when n is very far, the frequency range of 30 to 200 MHz. Now for the frequency range 130 MHz to 2000 megahertz, and the distance range from 2 to 30 kilometer. Distance 2 kilometer to 30 kilometers. Clear? So this is the formula which I have used to find the prediction or path loss of area to area path loss model. Right? Now you can see here. Here I am telling, in the open area path loss model, basically this adjustment factor is the multiplication of this alpha naught equals to alpha 1 into alpha 2 into alpha 3 into alpha 4 into alpha 5, where these are the adjustment factor in the different situation. Now you can see this alpha 1 is the adjustment factor for new base station antenna height in meter divided by 30.48 meter whole square, because we know that 100 feet equals to 30.48 meter. So this is the adjustment factor for the new base station antenna height upon 30.48 whole square. And alpha 2, if you are putting now these heights in the feet, so this is the new base station antenna height in feet upon 100 feet whole square. So this is related to the alpha 1. Similarly, the parameter alpha 2, this is the alpha 2. Alpha 2 adjustment factor which define the new mobile unit antenna height in meter divided by 3 power V. Or this is the now height of the mobile unit in meters. If you are putting the height of mobile unit in feet, so this is the new mobile unit antenna height in feet. Basically we know that 3 meter equals to 10 feet. Power new, where the value of new is putting either 1 or 2. Either 1 or 2. Clear? When it is 1, when it is 1, in this situation, for the new mobile unit height less than 10 meter. If the, we can put this V equals to 1 if b equals to 1 when h2 is less than 3 meter. H2 is basically the height of the receiving antenna. H2 is the height of the receiving antenna or height of the mobile unit antenna. If mobile unit antenna height is less than 3 meter or less than 10 feet, now we can put this, the value of V is 1. The value of V is 2 when H2 is greater than 3 meter or 10 feet. So we can put basically these heights, right? And lastly, I am telling basically the F is the operating frequency while F0 is the fixed frequency at the 900 megahertz, right? And now you can see here the parameter, yeah, adjustment factor 3, that is the alpha 3. Alpha 3 defined by the, this is equals to new transmitted power upon 10 watt. New transmitted power upon 10 watt defines the adjustment factor alpha 3. And alpha 4 is defined the new base station antenna gain with respect to lambda by 2 dipole. With respect to lambda by 2 dipole means that is half wave dipole antenna. The new base station antenna gain with respect to half wave dipole antenna divided by 4. And alpha 5, this is the adjustment factor which defines the different antenna gain correction factor at the mobile unit. So these are the basically different adjustment factor define the different situations, right? When you predict the path loss between transmitting antenna and receiving antenna, you have to assume some predefined value. You have to assume some predefined value means the frequency F0, you have to choose the 900 MHz and the height of the base station antenna is 100 feet or 30.48 meter and the height of the mobile unit antenna is 3 meter or 10 feet while the base station power at the antenna is 10 watts and the base station antenna gain is 6 dB above the dipole gain. The mobile unit antenna height is 3 meter or 10 feet while the mobile unit antenna gain is 0 dB. 0 dB means 1 milliwatt power above the dipole gain. So when you design, you have find, use this formula, this method to predict the propagation path loss between transmitting and receiving antenna in open areas. Now you have to choose, you have to assume now these predefined values. Right? And next is the model of Okumara. Basically, the model of Okumara is used to find the propagation path loss between the open area, especially for the human made environment. Human made environment means basically if there are some buildings, some towers are present in between the transmitting antenna and receiving antenna. For example, suppose this is the base station or transmitting antenna and this is the mobile user or mobile unit, in between maybe some buildings. Some buildings are present, some towers are present, then how are signal strengths affected between these objects, these human made objects? How our signal strength is affect, how many losses, how much losses occur between the transmitting and receiving antenna because of the human made environment. So this is defined by the scientist Okumura. That's why this model is known as Okumura model. So in Okumura model, basically the Okumura assume that the base station height is 200 meter. He assume now this is the 200 meter of the base station height or this is the 656 feet. Okumura assume that the base station height is 200 meter or 656 feet and assume that the mobile antenna height, basically this height, h2 equals to 3 meter or 10 feet. And he found that the correction factor for the different antenna heights are as follows. First, the base station antenna height correction is 20 log h1 dash upon 200 meter, where h1 dash is the new height of the base station. New height of the base station antenna. So this is basically 20 log h1 dash upon 200 meter. While now this h1 dash must be greater than 10 meter. Yeah. Next, for the mobile unit antenna height correction is defined by 10 log h2 dash upon 3 meter, because 3 meter is the, we assume that the height of the receiving antenna, and 200 meter is the height of the transmitting antenna. Clear? Here h2 dash is basically the new mobile unit antenna height. This is the new mobile unit antenna height. Now practically this h2 dash must be ranging between 3 meter to 5. This h2 dash must be in the range of 3 meter to 5 meter. Clear? And third one is the mobile unit antenna height correction. Basically this is not 3, this is the 5 to 10. This is the 3 to 10 meter. The ranging from this h2 dash is 3 meter to 10 meter. Basically the curve of the Okumura model traces the curve between this correction factor. This is the correction factor. Now you can see the next slide. This is the waveform of the Okumura model, which is based on the antenna height, base station antenna height, and the receiving mobile unit antenna height. While kept the base station antenna is the 200 meter, receiving antenna height is the 3 meter. So he plot the curve or graph between the, he plot the graph between basically the median attenuation with the frequency. This is the median attenuation. Median attenuation means basically this is the losses, path loss. This is the propagation path loss with respect to frequency. Clear? Basically, if we kept the frequency is 1000 MHz, what will be the path loss in the dB? If 2000, what will be the path loss? 3000, what will be the path loss? So these curves based on the different antenna heights and the different antenna height means base station antenna height and the mobile unit antenna height. Clear? And the next graph is the plotted of the correction factor with respect to the frequency. So this is the correction factor and with respect to frequency. At this frequency, what will be the correction factor? When you solve the numerical, when you find the numerical value of the propagation path loss, now these two waveforms is very very important. To find the at this frequency. For example, suppose this is the 200 MHz. At 200 MHz, what is the correction factor? This is approximately 6 dB. Similarly, at the 500 frequency, it is approximately 7 dB. So these curves are very important to find the numerical value of the correction factor to solve the numerical, to solve the physical or numerical value of the propagation path loss. So these are the Okumura model for predicting the propagation path loss in the flat region and the open areas. Now next, come to the point to point prediction path loss model. Before that, now what I am discussing here are related to the flat region, flat area prediction. In flat area of prediction basically, suppose this is the transmitting antenna, this is the earth surface or ground, suppose here the receiving antenna, height is the H2, this is the height of the base station or transmitting antenna is the H1. So there are two way of the transmission or reception. One, either by the direct wave, so this is known as the direct wave, other by the reflected wave. Suppose this, or maybe this, or maybe this, or maybe this. So these are from here to here, this is known as the reflected wave. So this wave model, the propagation path loss model is known as the flat terrain propagation path loss. This is for the flat terrain. Flat, why it is called flat terrain? Because the position of the base station antenna and the mobile unit antenna is at the same surface, same plane surface. This is the mobile unit, this is the base station. And the distance between these two are is the d, right? But now I'm going to discuss the point to point prediction path loss over hilly terrain. Hilly terrain means this base station and mobile unit are not situated at the fixed plane, surface plane, a plane surface. Maybe sometimes this base station is situated at some hill and this is the some the flat plane. Sometimes this receiving antenna is places at the some hills and this base station is places at the some flat area. Yeah, so there are two situations of the point to point prediction. The situation first, so this prediction path loss of the hilly area is depend upon the two reason. One, point to point prediction. Point to point prediction over non-obstructive medium. Point to point prediction over non-obstructive condition. And second situation is point to point prediction over obstructive condition. Obstructive condition means the loss corresponding to this situation is known as the, this is known as shadow loss or diffraction loss. Shadow loss or diffraction loss, and basically this corresponding to point to point prediction over non obstructive condition, this is known as reflection loss. Yeah, so now I am going to discuss the first condition, so point to point prediction over the non obstructive. Non obstructive means there is no any object present in between transmitting and receiving antenna. Why? There are two types of this situation. Two types means you can see from this diagram. Now you can see from the next slide, there are two types of the circuit diagram. This is the general model for the flat terrain model path propagation over the flat terrain. Now I am going to discuss about the propagation over the hilly area. Hilly area means there are two situations means, now you can see this is the flat area, flat region where the base station is situated. This is the base station antenna height, antenna, and this is the mobile user. Here base station is fixed at the plane region. While the mobile unit is fixed at the some slopy area, some hilly region. So this is known as type A. Type A means, in type A, the mobile antenna is located on the slope and the base station is located on the level flat terrain. This is the type A. And in type B, now you can see the base station is located at the slope while the mobile unit is located at the flat terrain. So there are two types considered for the for predicting the propagation path loss. Clear? Dekho, there are two situations for the transmission and reception. One situation, the wave directly goes to the receiving antenna. The wave directly goes to the base station through mobile unit. This is known as the direct wave. Other is by the reflection. By reflection is other by reflecting at this point, then goes to here, or goes here and goes to here. So there are two type of reflection. This reflection point is known as specular reflection. What is called reflection? Specular reflection, because the power of this reflected wave is much higher than the power of this reflected wave. Why? Because this reflection point is very close to the this mobile unit. Very close to the mobile unit. That's why its power content is very high compared to this. So this reflection point is basically, there are two reflection points. The reflection point which is very near to the mobile unit, known as the specular reflection point. This is the reflection point which is more far away from the mobile unit. So this point is known as diffusely scattered reflection point. Similarly here, there are three situations. Either wave coming from base station to mobile unit is the directly, this is known as direct wave. Other by the reflected wave. Suppose this is the first reflected wave, this is the second reflected wave. Right? So this reflection point is very close, very near to the mobile unit. So this is again known as specular reflection point. And this reflection point is very far away from the mobile unit. This is the mobile unit. So this is known as diffusely scattered. Diffusely scattered reflection point. Now here there are two situations is considered. One is when base station is situated at the flat terrain, while the mobile unit is the slope of the hill or some slopey region. Type second, the base station is put on the some slopey region, maybe hill, and the receiving antenna or mobile unit is put on the flat terrain. Now I am going to discuss how to predict the path loss for these two situations. Clear? If it tracks now these waveform very clearly, you can see from this diagram. You can see from this diagram, so this is the base station. H1 is the height of base station, and this is the receiving antenna. This H2 is the height of the receiving antenna, and this is the distance, capital H. Capital S represent the distance between the receiving antenna, or height between receiving antenna to the plane surface. So this is the difference in the height between the flat terrain and the elevated terrain. H2 is the height of the mobile antenna above ground level. H1 is the height of the base station antenna above ground level. Small r means basically this. Small r represent the distance between transmitting and receiving antenna. And this capital R capital R. Now you can see this is the foot of the hill. The capital R is the distance over which the terrain is flat. Now you can see at this point, now the terrain is flat and this is the sloping. Or you can see this is the hill foot. Hill foot, the distance between the flat terrain, distance over is the terrain is flat. And the R1 is the distance. Suppose this is the next diagram, you can see. Similarly, in other situation, you can also see this is the capital H, this is the H1, this is the H2, this is the distance between transmitting and receiving antenna, this is the capital R. Capital R means distance between the flat terrain and the slope of the terrain. Clear? Now, clearly, you can see the ray traces. Clearly, you can see the ray traces of these two types, type A and type B. Type A and type B. You can see. Now I am going to discuss. You can see here. Suppose this is the base station antenna. This is the flat terrain. It goes to the hill. Suppose this is the mobile unit. H1 is the height of this. This is the level, ground level. This height is H2. This is the height of H2. And from here to here, this is the capital H. This angle is psi. Psi is the phase difference between the direct wave and the reflected wave. So there are three situations of the wave propagation. One is wave coming directly to the mobile unit or receiving antenna. Other by here, then reflected to here. Other by here, then reflected to here. So this is the first reflected wave. This is the second reflected wave. Clear? This is the first reflected wave and this is the direct wave. Clear? This is the reflection point. This is the reflection point. Now the distance between the here to here is suppose R1. And this is the capital R. And this is the small r. Distance between transmitting antenna to receiving antenna, transmitter to receiver. This is the capital R, is the distance of transmitting antenna to flat region. And this is the R1 is the distance between the reflection point, first reflection point. Clear? When we analyze now this waveform, we will find actually. Now you can see this is equal to R1 upon H1 upon R1 equals to. Now you can see this is when we analyze. Now we will find H1 upon R1 is this height. H1 upon R1 equals to H2. This height H2 plus H upon R minus R1. When we arrive, basically this antenna height H1 upon distance from the first reflection point R1 equals to antenna height plus now this capital H divided by R minus R1. So from here, what is the actual value of this reflection point R1? So this is equals to H1 R minus R1 equals to H2 R1 plus H R1. H2 plus H R1. R H1 R equals to R1 H1 plus H2 plus capital H, where R1 equals to H1 R upon H1 plus H2 plus capital H. This is the distance of the reflection point, I mean this distance for the type A. So this is the type A. At the mathematical analysis, we will find basically this distance from the reflection point is equal to height of the base station antenna into the difference between the base station antenna to mobile unit antenna upon this height plus this transmitting antenna height, receiving antenna height plus this the this height. So this is the calculate the reflection point of the type A. In this situation, if this, now you can see here, this R1 is less than this capital R. For capital R is greater than R1, for this situation, now this reflection point is occurred. If this condition, if we put this hill foot is here, hill foot is here, now you, this condition will not happen. Now second reflected will not happen for R less than R1. Clear? For this situation, R, capital R is greater than small r1. Now the second reflected wave is goes to the receiving antenna. But for the this condition, if this capital R is less than R1, now this situation, this reflection will not happen or will not occur. These all are related to the type A. Similarly, you can say basically the reflection distance or reflection point distance from the base station antenna for the type B is, for type B, this is second diagram. Now you can see like this. Suppose this is the with the surface, this is the surface, at here, now situated, this is the base station antenna, and here, somewhere situated the receiving antenna. Now you can say this is the type B. Type B means receiver is situated at the flat terrain while transmitter is at the slope of the hill, some slopy regions, right? So now wave can be reached at the receiving antenna by the two ways. One is by direct wave, other by the reflected wave. So this is for the direct wave. And other is for the either come here and reflected to here, and other maybe come here and reflected here. Suppose this is the first reflected wave, this is the second reflected wave. These are the reflection point. This is the scattered reflection point, this is the diffusely scattered reflection point. The power corresponding to scattered reflected point is more than the diffusely scattered reflection point. Clear? For this situation, how to calculate now this distance? So this is the small r1 by, this is the capital R, and this is the distance between receiving and transmitting antenna at this height from here to, this is the capital H, and this angle is the phase difference between direct wave and the reflected wave. Clear? In this situation, now we can say that H2 upon R1 equals to this now you can see H1 plus H, now this height H1 plus H, height of the base station antenna to f upon r minus r bar. Total difference between total difference minus this distance r1 r1. Now from here you will find the r1 equals to h2 r minus r1 equals to r1 h1 plus. From here r1 equals to h2 r upon h1 plus h2 plus capital H. So this is for type A and this is for type B. Clear? In type A basically this reflected distance from reflection point to base station is basically distance between reflection point to receiving antenna. Yeah, now difference is only h2 r h1 r. So this is the difference. So actually how to calculate the reflection point for type A and for type B? Clear? So graphically you can see here these are the numerical related to basically this is the combined diagram. This is the combined diagram which considered the so many cases. Here I consider only two cases for type A and type B, but in this diagram you can see it considered the so many cases. So many cases means one case flat region, then the this region, other this region, its slope is lower at this condition, slope is slightly more at this condition, slope is more. So there are so many conditions situation considered in the same diagram. So these all are basically related to the point to point prediction of path loss. Whatever I discussed here, these all are related to the non-obstruction condition. Non-obstruction condition means there is no any object present in between transmitting antenna and the receiving antenna. Right? How to calculate the received power? In this situation, the received power is calculated. The received power can be expressed. Now you can see. The received power can be expressed. PR equals to ES upon 2 neta whole square, where ES is the electric field corresponding to scattered means this is the base station, this is the mobile unit, so these two the field related to ES, scattered field. And for here, this is the E0 field, direct wave denoted by E0, by reflected wave denoted by the scattered ES. Clear? So this we can put, this is equal to P0 1 upon 4 pi r by lambda whole square into 1 plus AV e to the power J delta sine whole square. Clear? Where delta sine is the phase difference. So this is equal to 2 pi by lambda into delta d. Where delta d is the path difference. In previous lecture, I discussed in detail basically the path difference and the phase difference. So this delta psi is the phase difference between the direct wave and the reflected wave. Clear? Clear? So this is, what is the relationship of ES? ES equals to, now E naught 1 plus AB e to the power j delta psi. Clear? So this field, this is related to the power related to this E naught. E naught square. This quantity is E naught. Where E naught equals to? By r by lambda whole square into pt, where this p naught is related to the pt, gt and gr. Gt is the gain of transmitting antenna, gr is the gain of receiving antenna, pt is the transmitter power. For isotropic antenna, for isotropic antenna, now this gt gr equals to 1. For this situation, now this pt equals to p naught. Right? So this is the received power at this situation. Clear? For example, suppose the phase difference delta psi 1 is the phase difference between direct wave and first reflected wave, and delta psi 2 is the phase difference between the direct wave and the second reflected wave. Clear? Phase difference between direct wave, and suppose this is the first reflected wave, this is the second reflected wave. The phase difference between these two is denoted by delta psi 1, and phase difference between these two is denoted by the delta psi 2. Yeah, if we consider now these two conditions, we can write this equation equals to p naught 1 upon 4 pi r by lambda whole square 1 plus a b e to the power j delta psi 1 plus a b e to the power j delta psi 2 whole square. Okay? This AB equals to 0, minus 1. Reflection coefficient equals to minus 1 when theta I equals to theta r. Suppose this angle, if you consider here, suppose this angle is theta I and this angle is theta r. If these two are equal, now this reflection coefficient equals to minus 1. Then we can put this is equals to B naught 1 upon 4 pi r by lambda whole square mod 1 minus e power j delta psi 1 minus e power j delta psi 2 whole square. Right? This is the received power at the mobile unit with respect to different propagation path has different phase difference. Now we know that if theta is very small, we can put sine theta equals to theta and cos theta equals to approximately 1. Cos 0 is 1, if theta is very small, now we assume that now cos theta is 1. Now apply same condition for here. So for cos of delta psi 1 is approximately equals to 1, while sin delta psi 1 is approximately delta psi 1 for delta psi 1 is very small. Similarly, consider the next two cases. Cos of delta psi 2 is approximately equals to 1. Sin of delta psi 2 is approximately equals to delta psi 2. This is for when delta psi 2 is very small. Apply this condition to in this equation. apply this condition in this equation. Now we know that basically this delta psi from the previous equation, when distance between the transmitter and receiver is much greater than h1 plus h2, now this path difference delta d equals to 2h1 s2 upon d, when difference between transmitting and receiving antenna is much higher than the height of transmitting antenna plus height of the receiving antenna. That situation, the path difference is equals to 2h1 s2 upon d. Then phase difference delta psi equals to 2 pi by lambda into this path difference delta d. Now this is 4 pi h1 h2 upon d lambda. Clear? So for this situation now this delta psi 1 equals to 4 pi h1 h2 upon d lambda 1, and for this situation here delta psi 2 equals to 4 pi h1 h2 upon d lambda 2. Clear? Substitute these value the given equation. So we will find, now this equation become, now reduce to this PR equals to P naught 1 upon 4 pi R by lambda whole square 1 plus 2 delta 1 plus 2 delta psi 1 delta psi 2 because 1 plus a power n, if a is very small we can put this is 1 plus n a. Applying this condition, this is equal to delta psi 1 delta psi 2 power 2. So this part is very small, so this is 2 times of the delta psi 1 and delta psi 2. So suppose this is equation number, this is equation number 1, this is equation number 2. So this is the received power related to this situation. Clear? So this basically this is related to the free space transmission, but our way reflected by some medium, so it may be the some attenuation factor, so we can put here the alpha is the attenuation factor for this situation, right? Clear? If the alpha means attenuation factor, suppose this is the base station, this is the mobile station. If direct wave denoted by alpha naught, this is the, suppose this is the alpha 2, this is the alpha 1. Alpha 1, this is first reflected wave denoted by the attenuation factor alpha 1. Second reflected wave denoted by the attenuation alpha 2, this is the direct wave. If all these situations, alpha naught equals to alpha 1, equals to alpha 2, for this situation now this received power can be expressed like this. Clear? Because now this delta psi 1 delta psi 2 is very small, we can put this equation is PR equals to alpha P naught 1 upon 4 pi R by lambda whole square. And we assume that the uniform attenuation, uniform losses in the direct wave and the reflected wave, but if these losses are non-uniform, means losses corresponding to direct wave and losses corresponding to reflected wave are different, then we cannot put the attenuation factor the same. Then it is denoted by the received power is basically denoted by P naught 1 upon 4 by R by lambda whole square 1 either this is the alpha naught plus
AB is minus 1, alpha naught minus alpha 1 e to the power j delta psi 1 minus alpha 2 e to the power j delta psi 2. This is equation number 3. This is the attenuation corresponding to direct wave, attenuation corresponding to first reflected wave, alpha 2 is the attenuation corresponding to second reflected wave. Okay? This is the power square. So this is the formula related to the point to point prediction for type A and type B. Clear? So this is for the non-obstructive condition. Next, and other the point-to-point prediction for the obstructive condition. Obstructive condition means if there is any object present in between the transmitting antenna and the receiving antenna. So you can see that situation. For example, here if we assume that now this from here. If we assume that now alpha naught is approximately equal to alpha 1, because this reflection point is much far away from the mobile unit. This is the base station antenna, this is the mobile unit antenna, this is the reflection point. This reflection point is known as the specular reflection point, and this is the diffusely scattered. This reflection point is much far away from the mobile unit, and this is the very close to the mobile unit. If you assume that the this attenuation factor alpha 1 is very close to this alpha naught and alpha 2 is this. Now in this situation this P r equals to P naught 1 upon 4 pi r by lambda whole square r by lambda whole square. Into this is 1 minus alpha 2 e to the power j delta psi 2 whole square. This is equation number 4. Because we assume that from this alpha 1 and alpha naught equals to 1. If both are same, both are same. Now this quantity is cancelled by this quantity. So you will get actually this is this situation. Yeah. So this is the received power at the receiver side by the direct wave and reflected wave in the case of non-obstructive conditions. Yeah. In the next lecture, I will discuss about the point-to-point prediction with the obstructive condition. Obstructive condition means if there is any object present in between the transmitting antenna and the receiving antenna. Yeah. Thank you.